strength of this, we bless your holy name. The living world, we thank you.
Thank you, Father.
The one that has silenced the mouth of the lion before Daniel, who has silenced the mouth of the lion before us in this family, we magnify your holy name.
Hallelujah.
Thank you. There is no one like you. When you move, any power that want to barricade your movement, you destroy such power. Lord, we give you all the glory. And your promises upon our lives will come to pass in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Today, minister your word into our soul, spirit, and body in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
And at the end of our meeting today, holy your name, and your name shall be glorified in this family in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Thank you, our Lord.
Thank you, Father.
For in Jesus' name we are praying.
Amen.
Let's give a round of applause to the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords, the Ancient of Days, the I Am, the I Am. Tell your neighbor, this year, I'm telling you, this year,
and
you say, I'm telling you,
it's my year of divine release.
Whether Satan like it or not, in the name of Jesus, today, my divine release. It's coming to me.
There is nothing.
Any satanic agent can do
about that.
In the name of Jesus. Praise the Lord. And we take our conquering word for the week quickly. We look at it before we go into the work. For this week, what the Lord is asking us to meditate upon is Hebrews 4, 15 to 16. And it says, for we have not an high priest, that is our Lord Jesus Christ, which cannot be touched with the feeling of our infirmities. He knows what we are going through. But with all, was in all points tempted as we are. I don't know that temptation you are thinking that is too high for you. Jesus Christ was tempted as well. Yes, without sin. You see, the weather is cold, that's why I go fornication or whatever. That I was tempted because Satan tempted Jesus to have power. No. I give you all the power. No, don't say because the power I have to sin. Let us therefore come boldly unto the throne of grace that we may obtain mercy and find grace to help in time of need. Come and pray. The Lord you serve, and the Savior to whom you look, is not a stranger to your current struggles and trials, but he fills them with intimate acquaintance. He is not disinterested or cool to what you are going through. No. He came to this earth and took up our human nature precisely so that he might now be able to have a fellow feeling with us. Therefore, be rest assured that he is eminently able to represent you before the throne of his heavenly Father, leading your cause, securing your place, giving you the spiritual resources you might need this week and beyond in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
The Lord will strengthen you.
Amen.
He will help you.
Amen.
You will go through this week successfully and be healed in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
The topic we'll be sharing together this afternoon is my divine relief is approaching. My what?
Divine relief is approaching.
I don't know about yours, but now as I'm standing before you and before God, my divine relief is approaching. You can tell your neighbor if you have the boldness.
My divine needs.
So, no, tell your neighbor, you better be careful.
You better be careful.
So that when your divine name asks, and then your friend will say, you told me to be careful. Praise the Lord. Let's open our Bible to the book of Acts of Apostles 11. I'm going to read from 27 to 13, then we read from 21 to 3. So I will just continue Acts 11, 27 to 30, then we continue with Acts 2, 1 to 3. You know the scripture is written like that, it's in school. They follow each other like that. So it's the same thing going on. 27. And in these days came prophets from Jerusalem unto Antioch, and there stood up one of them named Agabus, and signified by the Spirit that there should be great doubt throughout all the world, which came to pass in the days of Claudius Caesar. Then the disciples, every man according to his ability, determined to send relief unto the brethren which dwelt in Judea, which also they did, and sent it to the elders by the hands of Barnabas and Saul. Now about that time, Herod the king stretched forth his arms to fetch certain of the church, and he killed James, the brother of John, with a sword. And because he saw it pleased the Jews, he proceeded further to take Peter also. Then was this of the unleavened bread. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Before relief arrives, however, problems often pop up, seemingly out of nowhere. If you are truly an overcomer, this is the pattern of life that overcomers live with. You are expecting that, yes, the pain should come, but somewhere, somehow, Satan will just rear his ugly head. And you will think that, am I the only one in the whole world? Why is all this thing happening to me? But what I'm telling you now, that God asked me to say, is that your divine relief is on its way to you in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Usually when we look at this issue, that unusually strong fixation, that is unusually strong issues, from left, right, backward, front, will be coming at a certain point in our lives. And when they are coming like that, there is also unusually great relief being gathered from heaven to be sent to you. And that will be your portion today in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
No! Sending the relief. And that relief is coming to you today in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
So this message is going to answer one of your long-awaited prayer requests in your life in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
That is what this message is going to do. One of your long-awaited prayer requests that you have been asking God. God is becoming unbearable. At the point in time, we say, God, where is your face? It's becoming unbearable. But it's at that point that the God's relief will be coming into that situation in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Someone needs a very serious financial assistance. Without this, it seems you cannot move forward. This message is bringing that financial relief into your destiny in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
I think you know what I'm saying, that the Lord is talking about. It's not that, Lord, I don't want to eat this bread, I want to eat cake. The word is it, we're not talking about that. If you financial hardship, that without it you cannot move further, then the Lord is saying, you are moving forward in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Because that relief is coming from heaven. Just like our deacon described this gift testimony. God, send that financial relief to her. The Lord that has done that to her will do it for you today in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
This message today is going to do something spectacular in your life. And it's going to be the repentance of the oppressor in your life. It's either the oppressor repents or the oppressor will be removed totally in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
It's going to do that. That has been pressuring your life. Either from your father's house, your mother's house, where in your campus, where you live, or anywhere in your environment. That oppressor is going to repent, or that oppressor, that power will be removed entirely from your life today in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
A loved one of you all is sick, and you have been crying, praying very hard, and it's wearing you down. You know, we have what they call carer's leave. I think some of us, we know the meaning of carer's leave. You are tired of looking after someone. You want to take a leave. There is going to be full physical and psychological healing for that your loved one in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Because you have reached to that wall. Say, I'm tired. I don't think I can go ahead with this. Lord, send his healing hand upon that your loved one in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
There is going to be timely blessing for you today because you are hearing this word of the Lord. And that timely blessing will lift up that burden from your shoulders in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Those are the things God is going to do for you today. What happened here in this book of Acts 11? The Judean brethren were in trouble. Prophet Agabus prophesied that there will be famine in the whole world. And many of the brethren in Judah, they were living just average, trusting God for prosperity. So they were wondering what is going to happen now. And the church there happened to be in Antioch, happened to be one of the biggest church, large and great church. And the brethren were disturbed. But why the brethren were disturbed? There was a plan that God has been made through the brethren to send Brother Barnabas and Saul to go and give them gift to relieve the famine from their lives. Relief was coming, but Judean brethren came under direct attack. Very ferocious attack of King Herod Agrippa I. First in the church. First of all, as we have read in that Acts 12, this Herod killed James, the brother of John, with what? With sword. The next thing he did, he saw that pleased people. Then he got this apostle, fisherman turned preacher, Peter, and put him into prison. We fought for children of soldiers so that after Easter, he will bring him out and do what? And crucify him. And the brethren in Judea, they were also looking at famine is coming. What is going to happen to them? King Herod is troubling the church. Every King Herod troubling your life will be destroyed today in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Every King Herod troubling the Overcomer Christian Fellowship International will be destroyed today in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
To prison, going to kill after the Easter. And then what is going to happen? It's just like the situations that are going on all over the world now, especially the Muslim countries where the Christians are being murdered. In the northeast of Nigeria, Christians are being murdered, not only persecuted, but being murdered, being killed. And we heard last week about 21 Coptic Christians from Egypt were killed in Syria. That was the kind of thing that was going on during that period. Even to come out as Christians, you need to be very careful. The brethren were going through that. But one thing that was happening, Judah brethren were not aware that God has been preparing relief to come to death. You don't know that the relief is coming. But I'm telling you that the Lord is saying that divine relief to lift you out of that predicament. You are thinking, God, what is going to happen is on its way to you in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
It's on its way to you! Isn't that the case? When I saw you, he spoke in Isaiah 59, verse 19. When the enemy shall come like what? Like flood. The Spirit of the Lord will do what? Will lift up standard against him. Every flood of the enemy. Because that is the way it looked like. This one calling you, I have this problem. That one calling you, I have this problem. You have to look after someone that is, well, you have to do this, you have to do that. You'll be wondering, this one is too much on me. The Spirit of the Lord will lift up standard against that storm in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
That was what was happening. Because we look at our lives. Am I the only one in the whole world? Someone spoke to me and said, after all, I wasn't the firstborn. Then why are they piling the whole problems in the Palm family upon my head? Say, you are not the firstborn, but God has made you the firstborn. And the Lord will give you the strength to carry the responsibilities. And I know some of us are thinking like that. You are not the firstborn. That the responsibilities upon you are more than the responsibility of the firstborn. The Lord will help you, will strengthen you,
amen,
and will make you to overcome in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
You'll be wondering why the vicious attack at this time. Why? The brethren in Judah, they were doing that. But they were doing that vigil. You see, when Christians are still enjoying a little bit, that is when they say there's no need of night vigil. But when the situation comes, who will tell you not to do the night vigil? You even forget to eat, not that you're fasting. The brother in Judea, they were doing night vigil. That this first session was too much for them to carry. Their leader has been arrested, put in the prison yard. They were praying. The prayers of the prayer warriors in this church will not go in vain in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Our lives will not go in vain. They were praying. And what happened? Angel went to Peter. Get up. The soldiers were there. Satanic soldiers surrounding you. The angel of the Lord will blindfold them in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
So that your relief can come. So, Peter was asked to come out. By the time Peter left the prison there, he said, it looked as if I was seeing vision. Because it was a great miracle. That great miracle will be your portion today in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Why? Satan saw that God's relief was on the way for the brethren in Judah. And the next thing Satan has to do is to do what? To discourage them, to crush their spirit. We have been preparing, getting ready for the convention. Eh? For one satanic agent to be now discouraging you from getting your blessing. God will silence that power in your life in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
That is what the church is saying. Want to discourage the brethren there? Want to crush their spirits? Because Satan knows that. The relief from God is on his way. And he will not like you to enjoy the relief. So the first thing is to just dampen the spirit. But I'm telling you today that God forever will encourage you.
Amen.
Will strengthen you.
Amen.
Till you have your breakthrough in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Second is to test our faith and loyalty to him. You may be wondering, why am I getting all these things? God is trying to test your faith and your loyalty, whether you are going to back up. Say, no, I'm no more interested in the things of God. That is the scheme of Satan and his agents. Any power that wants to take your faith, want to remove you from being loyal to the God, will be perished today in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
God is going to display his amazing overcoming power over your situation. That is why when things are coming, rolling up, the issues are piling up, so there are these solutions are on the way. And the Lord will use his overcoming power to crush the head of the wicked upon your destiny in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Divine judgment came upon King Herod. That's chapter 2. If you read verses 21 to 23, because it has to happen. Herod! At the set day, the scripture says set day. God has said that Herod is going to be destroyed for vexing the church. The same day of the enemy of this church is at hand. And the Lord will destroy the Herod of this ministry in the name of Jesus!
Amen!
Like it happened to Herod Agrippa 1. He made a noise like a speech. And he said, this speech looked like a God's voice. And he didn't give glory to the Lord. What happened to him? One angel did what? Slap him. And he died, and the worm hurt him. I command the angelic slap to destroy the error in your life in the name of Jesus.
Yeah.
It's to teach us that the enemy often attacks us just before divine help arrives to relieve us. So when you are saying things like that, please, I want you to take note that divine relief is on its way to me. I know. So that is why all these things were coming. The Lord will see you through in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Something happened in 1 Samuel 30, which we know. David's relief was in his way. He was a sick lad. 1 Samuel 33 to 6 Samuel. Ziklag, he has the wrong guy. He was running for his life because of Saul. And we know what happened. The Amalekites came. David did not know that God has been getting him ready for relief to come to him. He was running away from Saul. He left the land of Israel, went to Ziklag among the Philistines. The Amalekites came. While they were not around, they took the wives, they took the children, they took everything. They burned their houses like Boko Haram were burning the houses in Northeast Nigeria. David came and the men. And the Bible says, they wept until they what? They couldn't weep again. How can men weep until they can't weep anymore? If it were women, we say the women are emotionally high. But when it comes to men, they don't weep in this country. Brother Brian, am I saying the right? They do like this.
We try not to.
God bless you. They do like this. They don't weep. And I know in another part of Nigeria, where I came from, when something is very painful, they don't cry. If you don't know the history, those of us from the northern part of Nigeria, I know, I've done research on that. In the 80s, at the university, when they go into labor, they don't cry. They come talk about the West and the Eastern, they cry a lot. So they cry from morning till evening. The scripture says David encouraged himself in the Lord. And he asked the Lord, can I pursue them? The Lord said, pursue them, you will overtake. And the Lord is telling you today as well, you will recover all that the enemy has stolen from you in Jesus' name. Yeah. You will pursue, you will overtake, and you will recover all in the name of Jesus. Yeah. Tell your neighbor, I will pursue,
I will overtake,
I will overtake,
I recover
all that the enemy has stolen from me.
Yeah.
David held to the rock that was higher than him. And he recovered all. If you read that 1 Samuel very well, when he brought all the spoils, when he recovered all, the Bible says he started distributing to his friends and to the other people in other parts of Israel. It was too much for him. You will be blessing to others in the name of Jesus.
Yeah.
Because of the divine relief that is coming to you now. That divine relief will give you the grace to be relief to others. Because God has sent you to be relief to others in the name of Jesus.
Yeah.
Maybe you were expecting £1,000 and you got £10,000. Won't you be looking for someone to bless?
Yeah.
And please, if you get that, remember the pastor. Praise the Lord.
Yeah.
Praise the
Lord.
Remember the pastor. Because it's only 1,000 you are asking for. But God is bringing you 10,000, 10 million pounds. So when you get that, I say, the pastor has said this. So remember me. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
This man, David, was overwhelmed. That he was not overcome. No power of darkness will overcome you in Jesus' name.
Amen.
On the third day, the news came to David that Saul and his three children have died. Though it pained David, but that was a kind of relief because this man was running helter-skelter for his life. When he got himself in this Ziklag episode, but he did not know that God has been preparing relief for him to recover all, to get one, to bless others, and for him to go and stay on the throne that God has prepared for him. Every servant riding on your horse, the Lord will remove that servant from your horse in the name of Jesus.
Yeah.
You are going to ride on that your horse in the name of Jesus. Come to Esther. Fasting misbehaved because it was the time for Esther to reign. That power sitting on your throne we misbehave, and you will go to your throne in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
That is the divine relief. That is the divine relief God is sending to you. Psalm 118, verse 13. Thou hast thrust hard at me that I might fall. But the Lord do what? The Lord helped me. Why the forces are coming like that? Just for you to fall. But I'm telling you, according to that word of God, the Lord will help you in Jesus' name.
Amen.
We say, divine relief that will give you peace all the days of your life in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
How do we contaminate this satanic onslaught? What are we going to do? The thief cometh not but to steal, to kill and destroy. Anything that is coming to steal your joy will be destroyed today in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Because Satan, thief, does not want us to be thanking God, to be praising today, to be rejoicing before Him. That is why all the pressures are coming. You know, one thing I thank God for is that when I look at your lives, I say, God, I thank you for the lives of the members in this church. Many of you have been telling me that if this church is not there, what will happen with your lives? Satan will not chase you away from where your blessings are in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
We are not ignorant of Satan's devices. So that's why we have to buckle up. We have to prevent Satan from robbing us of our joy. And I pray, any power that wants to rob you your joy in this church, the Holy Ghost fire will destroy that power in Jesus' name.
Amen.
There are simple, very simple responses we need to do. One is to believe this principle, that when the satanic vexations are so high, you have to believe and be practicing it. Then you should take note that the heavens are preparing something great to relieve you, and that will be your portion in Jesus' name.
Amen.
That is the first thing you should note. I've been using that principle so many times. When things are coming here and there, I say, God, I'm going to send your divine relief. I'm waiting for that. And God will truly just appear and say, yes, I have come. You will come into that situation today in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
As soon as you know that, the battle is 50% won. When you keep on believing that, that one will relieve you. And you will know that the battle is 50% won. The remaining 50% is for that divine relief to just come and set you free. And that will be your portion in Jesus' name.
Amen.
You have to meditate on it. Believe in it. Because faith comes by hearing what? Hearing the word of the Lord. So when you think that the heat of the trials, that heat is so much, remember, divine relief is coming to cool that heat off. And that heat upon your careers, academic family, will be cooled off by the power of the Lord in Jesus' name.
Amen.
You are so weak. Say, yes, I'm very weak. I'm telling you, divine relief from the Lord, we strengthen you in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
When you are at the danger point, thinking, yay, what is going to happen? The Lord will surface and help you out in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
The next one is to give thanks. We know in 1 Thessalonians 5:15, in everything, we give thanks. For this is what? The will of God in Christ Jesus concerning. I'm not saying you should be giving thanks for the vexation. Eh? No. But to be given thanks in it. I think my English is clear. Don't say, God, thank you for this sickness. No. What I'm telling you is that God, in this sickness, I'm thanking you because I'm going to be made whole. You have spoken in your word, Psalm 107, verse 20, that you sent your word out and healed me and delivered me from every destruction. Lord, I thank you for healing me. Because of your stripes, I have been healed over 2,000 years ago. Lord, I thank you because I'm healed. That is what I'm saying. We give thanks to him in everything. That brother, we're saying this, we tell him. Yes! Rabbi, dead. This one has come again, but I'm going to overcome it. That was the man. I always remember him for that. That in the name of Jesus, I'm going to overcome this as well. As soon as you have that in your mind, you are thanking God. You will be more than conquerors in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Our God is reliable. When we thank him, we are honoring him. When we thank him, we are saying, Lord, you are the only one that can do it. That's why I'm thanking you. I acknowledge your power in my life. That is what we are saying. And that is going to please the Lord because we are depending upon him. Just like what we are doing in our house fellowship this month, divine help from God. And we were coming here yesterday, we missed our train. Another train came. We entered it, and it took us to the next station. We came up. Lord, we didn't know what was happening. The train we missed has not arrived into that station. As soon as it arrived, we went into that train. We said, can you see? Divine help from God. Divine help from God. We missed that one, but God sent another one to quickly take us, express one, to the next train station. And then we got off. And then, is that not true? Brother, and we entered that one. Instead of penalizing us for entering the wrong tree, the Lord will send divine helper to you in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
The next one, the last one is to pray, pray, pray. Pray without ceasing. When you want to drink water, you do what? You pray. You want to eat food, you? Not to talk that when you want to have meeting. And you don't want to pray. What kind of meeting is that? A social club meeting. You pray! That's one thing I thank God for the Cameroon National House of Assembly. Before they start every session, they do what?
They
pray. And they are banning prayers here in our council, local council meetings. God will help us in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Prayer! Learn not always to pray and not to faint. When you think that the old things are coming, you have to pray. Pray until something happens because the relief is on the way. If you don't pray, how will the relief come? Daniel, pray! The relief was coming. And what happened? In the ambulance, Angel Gabriel, the power of passion and grace just held him there. But this man continued praying. Man of God. So I don't know what is happening to the Christians nowadays. Pray! And he prayed for 21 days. What happened? Another angel came from heaven, dislodged the power, and just brought the prayer request to Daniel. Your prayer request will be given to you today in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
You need to pray. Very well. That's why we pray 12 o'clock this afternoon as God instructed. Because this prayer, this ministry is prayer warrior ministry. It is not a social club. It's not the church we're going to be drinking tea. God bless you. Bye bye. No! And that is why Satan is not happy for your life, for my life, for the breakthroughs we are having in this church, for his power over our lives. No, Satan is not happy. Because of that, you will not relent in your prayer life in Jesus' name.
Amen.
The Lord will ignite your prayer altars for his own glory in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
You have to pray. Amen. how to pray, and how to flow. My brethren, when enemy comes in on you like a flood, don't rebel, don't faint. Have faith in the Lord. Now this one, I know the relief is coming. Don't stop doing God's will. Don't murmur. Some people, you know what happened to them? Some Christians, you know what they do? They blame everyone, including who? Including God. But they don't blame them. They are very perfect. It's God that is not perfect. So they blame the pastor, they blame everyone, they blame you, they blame everyone. They say God too. And because they see themselves as holy, blameless. No! Go unto the Lord! Cry unto him. Father, if it is my sin, forgive me. Some people, they just wandering in sin. And they think they bring the right thing. Please. You've done something wrong. You better go to the Lord. Say, God! I've sinned against you. This is one thing I like David for. Don't be still naked. Your destruction will come on such person. Go to the Lord. Lord, forgive me. I've done these wicked things before you. A prodigal son. Lord will help us in the name of Jesus. Remain confident. Although you cannot see, you cannot hear, you cannot touch what is happening, but you know God is doing something. He's bringing divine relief on his way to you. And God will send his relief to you today in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Shall we rise up? His love, his love, amen, he has risen from the dead, and he is alive. Every knee shall bow. Situation where you need the divine relief. Academically, in your business, in your marital life, over your children, over your spouse, and all the love, where you need that divine relief. You want the divine, relief is on its way to you. It's approaching you. It's approaching you. It's approaching you. It's approaching you. Divine relief is on its way to you. Divine relief, oh God. Divine relief that will bring divine relief is coming to you. Our God and our Father, we give you all the glory. We thank you for today because of what you have done in our midst. Because you have silenced the voice of the enemy running against our destiny, against our careers, against our academics, against our marital life, against our ministry. You have silenced that voice of the enemy, and that will be silenced forever in the name of Jesus. Lord, we are going up now. You have spoken. Divine relief that will bring divine release. I pray it will locate you.
Amen.
And overflow your life in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Thank you, our Lord.
Thank you.
As we are preparing our mind, our heart, our spirit for your divine release more, next week during our confession, Lord, you will strengthen your children to continue in you in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Any power that might want to discourage you, that might want to demotivate you, I bury that power alive today in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
We thank you, our Lord.
Thank you, Father.
We bless your holy name.
Hallelujah.
For in Jesus' name I pray.
Amen.
God bless you.